Okay, so till now we have just learned everything about factors, multiples, common factors, common multiples. Then we also learned about highest common factors, we learned about the lowest common multiple. Now you might be thinking, whether is there any application of these things what we have learned, of these mathematical concepts. So in this session precisely we are going to learn about how we can apply the concepts of HCF and LCM to real life problems. So let us start with an example which will show you how you can apply the concept of HCF to solve a problem. So let us say that there is a problem in which we have two tankers, okay, and the tanker 1 contains 850 liters and the tanker 2 contains 680 liters of oil. Okay, so I would say that this is tanker 1 and this is tanker 2, and this one has 850 liters and this one has 680 liters. Now what we want to do is we want to find out a maximum capacity of another container which can measure the oil of both the tankers when used an exact number of times. Now these wordings are a bit jumbled up and we have to really simplify what it means. So what essentially we want to do is we want to find out a tanker, right, a third tanker which can measure the oil in both the tankers equally. What I mean to say equally is that there should not be anything left, right? And that is one condition, that is you should not be having any oil left when you are trying to measure it with this tanker and with this tanker. And the second thing is that it should be of the maximum capacity. It means you have to find out what is the maximum possible capacity of the third tanker which you are going to use to measure this. Now if you just have a look at the problem, how do we analyze this? So we want to find out a third tanker which can measure both of these tankers, and it has to be of maximum capacity. The reason why we say it, how does the maximum capacity help us here? So that we have to do less measurements, right? You have to do less measurements. So now let us try to analyze this problem in a bit more detail. Okay, so the thing is we need a container that can divide oil in both the containers exactly, that is no oil should be left. So basically we are going to divide the oil in some other containers, in containers of some quantity, right? And that was the first requirement. And the second requirement, what we understand from simplifying the problem, is that the capacity of this container should be maximum value that can divide oil in both the containers without leaving any oil left in the containers. So if you see it, this is where we would like to use the highest common factor. Because if you recollect, what is highest common factor? What is HCF? HCF is the biggest number, right, for a set of biggest number which will divide both the numbers equally, right? Or we should say HCF is the highest common factor. That is what essentially we are going to find out here. Okay, so now let's try to find out the HCF of 680 and 850. Okay, so we first start with 850. So we start with, as you remember, we have to do a prime factorization for both the numbers 680 and 850. So we start with the number 2. Okay, when 2 is multiplied by 400, so when 2 we multiplied by 340, 2 3s are 6, 2 4s are 8 and 0. This is 340. This is 340. So when 2 is multiplied by 340, we get 680. Then again, we can divide this 340 by 2. So 2 times 170 will give me 340. Can I still divide 170 further with 2? Yes. Can take 2 multiplied by 85 gives me 170. Now, okay, what is it that I can divide this number? We can divide this by 5. If you recollect from our divisibility tests, So it is 5 pins are 5 and 3 is left, so we have 17. Right? Now there are other prime numbers between 5 and 17, but we see that none of them can divide 17, so we straight away go to 17, and 17 into 1 is 70. So these are the prime factors for the number 680. Okay, so and now let us find out the prime factors for the number 850. So we start with 2, 2 into 4, 25 gives me 850. Can I divide 425 by 2 anymore? No. But by the divisibility tests, I know that 425 can be divided by 5. So when I do 4 into 8 is 40, and so it is 85. I can still divide 85 by this thing. So 5 into 17 is 85. Now we have the 17 here, and as we know that there is no other number that is going to divide the 17, so I will write a 17. Ones are 17. So now let us write down the prime factors for both of these numbers. So we have the prime factors for 680 will be equal to 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 5 multiplied by 17. And then we have this for 850. We write the same prime factors for 850, and they will be 2 multiplied by 5 multiplied by 5 multiplied by 17. Now if you recollect the method for finding out the HCF from the prime factors, we just find out the numbers that occur. So we have this 2 here and we have this 2 here, so we can take this 2. Okay, so thus let's just write HCF equals 2 multiplied by, now do we have a 2? No. Do we have another 2? No. We do have 1 5. Okay, so these 2 5 is there, so we write it 5. Do we have another 5? No. We have 17 factors, 17 as a factor in both, so into 17. Now when we solve this, right, we get 10 multiplied by 17, which is equal to 170. So this is what we need. We need a container of 170 liters, right? And if you take a container of 170 liters, then it will divide 680 and 850 into exact parts without leaving anything. So now let me just reinforce the meaning of an HCF. So what is basically HCF? HCF is the highest number, which is a factor. Okay, which is the highest factor for both the numbers or more numbers, and it can divide them. That's the main idea, because it's a factor, so it can divide them. So that is the concept of HCF as we applied it to a